I'm really interested to understand better the impact of bushfire on communities and how their house and their neighborhood can stand up to those bushfires. I also look into understanding the people response, people behavior and perception during those bushfires. Combining the physical and the human aspect, it's really important to better understand the context of the loss and how we can help community becoming safer and more resilient. My name is Raphaele Blanchi. I'm leading the bushfire adaptation team at the CSIRO in the business unit environment. Through my career, I've been involved in post-bushfire survey, collecting data and analyzing those data after some of the main bushfire. For example, we have a big survey after the Black Saturday bushfire in 2009. And those information were really useful to help different type of agencies to develop policies for community education. And what I'm really most passionate about this work is how I can help the people to gain information and knowledge about bushfire, and with the goal at the end to make them more resilient. It's critical to have a good understanding of the bushfire and how it's going to impact on someone's properties and someone's house as well. I think this deep knowledge of bushfire is the first step of being safer, being able to take measures to protect your house, your property and your family as well. So the process of post-bushfire survey is about collecting data in situ, you know, just after the bushfire, where we want to understand, you know, what were the mechanisms of bushfire attack, you know, how the bushfire have arrived on a property and how this bushfire have attacked this property. So we're looking at, for example, exposure to embers, to flame as well, and to radiant heat, which is the heat of the fire that's going to arrive and impact on a property. But on the other side, we look at how this exposure have impacted this house. So we're looking at what type of materials the house is made, what type of windows. We're looking at the design as well, a different type of structure. But we also look at the surrounding elements, where the cars are, where the sheds are, where the vegetations, the garden vegetation is placed around the house, because those might contribute to the fire propagations to the house. And this is where it becomes really useful to collect all this information and how we're going to use this information for changing, so helping to inform a change in policies and reforms into the regulation, but also helping to inform community educations. We collect a lot of different type of information, like some on the building side of it. And we also collect information on people, you know, what they've done during bushfire, what they experienced during this bushfire, and what are their attitude and their actions and what they would do differently in the future as well. With this information, we can now provide, you know, advice for people on how to make their house safer and more resistant to the bushfire. Through you know, those information, we produce like different type of guidelines. So we've got online guidelines. It's called best practice to build in bushfire prone area. So all this information, we put it in guideline that is accessible and directly usable by the broader public. So they can find information about how to understand the weakness of their house, but they also can find information and measures that they can take to make the house safer and more resilient as well.